into a system. What was I before the heaven and the earth came to exist? What was I? Now, my friends, in the practitioner, the raised Buddha Dharma, that's the Sivao Shapatasma, and the practice method, we have practiced the direct method, that also sweep attachment. The direct method, that we go back to the fundamental of the attachment. The fundamental of attachment, that subjective and objective. The down, that's the automatically from sweep. We don't raise it at all to sweep. We don't have a subjective, objective of sweep. Sweep be now. So, the practitioner should be got this idea from practice matrix. If we attach, even we attach on the question, attach on the practice method, or attach on the doubt, because doubt different than the other. Doubt that is one kind of talk, but different than the other kind of talk. Because now that go back to second nature. Doubt, no dualism, no subjective, no objective. If you think that now just like objective to hold, objective to to stay, or to know that that become the attachment, but not released down. So the practice method always required practitioner mention sweep out sweep attachment. Mean that mention the nothing to gain, no gain in the down, nothing to seek, no seek the down, and nothing to fear. No fear, have doubt, or don't have doubt. The likewise, Zen master always at the practitioner to practice. We practice what how mean practice meditation. At question raising doubt, but you ask the question doubt not raising yes. No feeling the doubt, no knowing the doubt. But the part where I just add the question clearly, simply, continually, very simple. Just add and use the truth, use the real reality to add, no attach on the other talk. Just only one thing to do, one question to ask clearly. For example, before the heaven and the earth came to existence, what was I? Before the heaven and the earth came to existence, what was I? Just ask a question like that, from asking the question, because that is question, they have the question mark. Automatically, the doubt rising. The doubt rising from the question. You don't like to answer the question, don't find the answer, don't try to to find the thing to answer. That means we don't attach on the answer, because the question, like who was Zen master, he just said that, we give the example, like the question, just like the cane help the handicapped people, they cannot walk by their leg, that help they walk it. Exactly like the practitioner need the doubt. The question just raising doubt. So any or many kind of the question, just have one goal, that raising doubt. Raising doubt and maintaining doubt. But we, the doubt here different than the other, curiosity. The doubt, curiosity, because we gain something through the doubt. We see something through the doubt. We feel in doubt. We don't know that walk list, that nonsense doesn't make sense. We raise so many kind of talk like that. That means attachment. We call it knowledge. Our knowledge is very, very limited in the karma, limited to the habit. With the doubt, we'll find out, we'll go back to the real knowledge of the self nature, Buddha nature. So believe in the zone mind, also believe in the wisdom. Release the wisdom means relieve attachment, that practice. And symbol, very, very simply add the question clearly. We add question like that, we relieve attachment. Sometimes the symbol, like our habit, our talk, our thinking changes when get the experience in practice. So just practice to add the question clearly all the time, or the places, anywhere we add, because the practice in our mind, the people outside to know that, or know, require any kind of position, different position. Even we very sick, we lie down on the bed, or even in the hospital, we still add the question. We still practice very, very close to earth, to practice. Kính thưa quý thầy, quý sư cô, cùng toàn thể bạn đồng tham. Hôm nay chủ nhật.
Dear Dhamma friends and all practitioners, it's the second day of the new year. It's time again for us to ask questions and share experience in our practice. The topic for this is Year of Dragons, springtime's Year of Dragons. No matter if it's a new year or a regular day, we're still doing the practice normally, regularly. We still celebrate for the new year, but we don't forget our practice. When you practice the right Dharma, you have to detach yourself from all thinking. Any understanding or any knowledge arises from your mind, you have to detach yourself from that. When you already create a knowledge, understanding, you have to detach yourself from that by doing your practice. Practice will sweep up all of the thinking created by your mind. Sometimes new practitioners, they still don't understand how to detach yourself from these thinking. And they forgot to do the practice because of the habit, because of ignorance that we've been having a lot from previous life and this life. And we still attach ourselves to these thinkings. That is so pity for people who don't practice. And it's lucky to have a Dharma, the right Dharma to practice in this life. And you meet that, you have that, and you don't practice. When you think that you practice diligently, when you think that you about to get a lot enlightenment, or you think that you are already a Buddha, that is all your thinking in the head. That is according to Minbon Zen Master. When you detach yourself from all the thinking, that is the right way to practice. When you still know that you have no attachments, or you have detached yourself from all the thinking, which means you still attach to your thinking until you're practicing without knowing that you practice, without knowing that you're practicing. That is the right way of practice. But just like in the sutra, when we talk about toleration, you tolerate everything without knowing that you tolerate anything. That is the true toleration. So the same, when you're doing a practice, you're doing a practice not knowing that you're doing your practice, that is a true practice. It is important for you to ask questions when you have any problem during the practicing. In the Pháp Hoa Sutra, the female dragons still have to ask questions from the Buddha in order to get the right Dharma to practice. Same in the Thiện Tài Đồng Tử is also going to find the right Dharma in order to find the right Dharma. Thiện Tài Đồng Tử has to go and to many wise men in order to get the right Dharma to practice, in order to reach his Buddha nature. So asking questions and sharing experience is very important for all practitioners.
Chư tổ sư cũng vậy, cũng vì cái cầu pháp giải thoát mà phải đi.
For the Buddha, for the patriarch, in order to get the right Dharma to practice, they trade in everything, even their lives, in order to get the right Dharma to practice. So, according to the Buddha teaching, we always relied on the four. Right ways to practice in order to go on the right way.
Đối với lại cái thời tổ cận đại cũng vậy. Hiện tại thì Phật pháp bao la và cái sự phát triển
về those present patriarch, they still using words and explanations to explain about the way for us to practice in the right way. Sometimes we feel like there are too much to listen to, too much to learn and study for, and we sometimes attach ourselves to these thinking, and forgot to do the practice just because we don't have the eyes of wisdom to look and see the right Dharma. It's just like a king of a swan who can separate the
nó uống nước với sữa, sữa với nước hòa hợp thì nó tan hết trong trong nước, rất là khó phân
milk
ra.
And water.
Của nó.
So when
khi mà nó uống vô nó thì nó
the king of swan
sữa và
drank
nó ói ra lại là nước.
The mixture of water and milk, they can absorb only the milk and they spit out all those water. So the Buddha used this example of the king of swan in order to tell people to be able to see the right Dharma and stay away from those wrong viewing that you had when doing the practice. Just like in tính tâm minh home,
mới có không có một cái nỗi niềm sân hận, nỗi bực bội gì.
When
tâm cả không
it said that when you have belief in the right Dharma, you don't have a dualistic mind. When you have a dualistic mind,
từ đó mình mới rút ra kinh nghiệm sống, kinh nghiệm tu tập.
Which means you are not believe in your own Buddha nature. When you heard that we have to detach ourselves from all the thinking in the head, and when you hear nothing to fear, nothing to gain, and nothing to fear, we know that we have to go back to our practice and continue to practice. If you have any questions or want to share your experience, go ahead and speak up.
Mời cô Quan.
Miss Quan.
Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Tôi xin chỉ.就是我理解我们来到人间第一个要寻求自我解脱第二个要利益众生那我们怎么能够在帮助别人的时候不会陷入能所 我的感觉就是，如果我们去掉了我执和分别心，有一定的开悟，那么我们会自然而然的在帮助别人的时候，不会陷入能所。不知道这样理解对不对？好。
Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật.
Kính bạch
thầy, con có một cái nghĩ suy như thế này. Cô Quang nói rằng biết rằng chúng ta sanh ra ở đời này, một là muốn cầu pháp để giải thoát, hai là từ đó để đi mà lợi ích cho chúng sanh.
Thinking,
thì biết rằng
when
khi
we're born
chúng ta
in this world,
sự việc lợi ích cho chúng
we,
sanh đó, thì chúng ta
always want
bị kẹt vào trong cái gọi là
to
mà có phải là nhờ vào sự công phu tu
fight a right
chúng
dharma
ta sẽ không còn có
and
cái
then
gọi là ngã chấp
we
và cái
want
phân biệt đó
to have
còn nữa
other people
cô muốn hiểu
to
có phải đúng là như vậy
practice
không?
The right dharma too. So when we want
cái,
to help other to do the dharma
lời của Phật
the
dạy
way
là,
that we still in a dualistic mind
thành Bồ Tát đạo
that is true
trên cái phương
when
tiếp của Đại
the
Thừa,
Buddha said
tức là
that we
Bồ Tát đạo đó
practicing
tức là cái Bồ Tát đạo
to attain
đạo
enlightenment
đạo
and then go and help others, we have to have the right understanding of his words. When we practice a bodhisattva practice, we are practicing the six levels of
tức là phá ngã chấp vô sở đắc mà nha vô sở đắc là phá ngã chấp cho nên nó viên mãn bồ đề
practices
vô sở đắc đến cái viên mãn bồ đề không còn cái năng sở đắc đó nữa
we have
thì
to,
nói về bố thí độ đi ví dụ như bố thí thì
do
bố thí ra năm cái kia trên cái hạnh bố thí đây bố thí bằng
goodness
lời, bằng suy nghĩ bằng tài vật
by
sắc
doing
chất,
the practicing
đất nước gió lửa vân vân
and doing the practice without knowing that we doing the practice
nó rất là gắt gỏng mình nói rất là mâu thuẫn trước khi nói xiên nói xỏ nói xéo
we
nói hớt nói giỡn nói đùa
sometimes said that we doing the Buddha bodhisattva
tại vì đều là bởi
practice
nó mới sanh
but
ra
we still
cái
attach ourselves to what
đó,
we doing.
Đó.
We still attach ourselves
thì,
to the
đạo,
thinking of doing.
Hành, hay là nói về cái nhận
and
we
still
à,
know
thì,
that
we
doing
bố thí thôi,
the bodhisattva practice.
Từ cái lời
and
nói,
that is not
chỉ,
going on
là bố thí. Trên cái
the
hòa,
right way.
Trên cái
when the bodhisattva doing the practice, helping
người
other
khổ,
people,
không có làm người
they there's
đó,
not,
gọi là
no one for them
thí độ. Mà
to help,
mình còn biết mình á,
nothing for
mình
them
ái
to
hay là mình bố thí á,
help,
vẫn chưa phải là
and
mật á. Mình làm đến mà cái sự thuần tục bố thí đó, đến mình không thấy mình bố
don't
thí,
know
không thấy
that we have. We are the one that's doing the help and that other people for us to help. So they doing the help without knowing that they're helping because they always in the practice of detaching their mind from everything by doing the practice. So everything, including in their practice, and until they attain the enlightenment, then everything is enough. So others' methods, the right methods, you have to detach yourself from everything. When you see that you practicing diligently and you know that you're practicing diligently, which means you are not going on the right path. There's nothing for you to attain, nothing for you to ask for, and nothing for you to fear of. So, as the sixth patriarch said, that when you practice, you don't know that you practice, that's the right way of practice. And when you still see that you practicing, which means you're still attaching to your practicing. And sometimes you thought that is the ultimate goal of your practice because you're still thinking, you're still attaching to your thinking. And that is so pretty. Thinking that you have are just the thing or the creation of your mind. So when you think, you have to remind yourself to go back to your practice. When you practice, you have already helped other people. So, is that understandable? Yes, thank you. Miss Kim In.
Dạ, Nam Mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. À, con kính thưa quý thầy, quý sư cô cùng thường đường đại chúng. À, con xin thầy khai thị cho chị hành giả mới tham thì cũng được thời gian rồi đó thầy.
Could you please
cũng là,
give us some words and encouragement for a new practitioner
công phu một thời gian nhưng mà cảm thấy
who'd been practicing for a while and still have some frustrations that she practicing the patriarch Zen and still going to other methods just like chanting the Buddha names and chanting the Buddha Sutra and feel like she have to do everything to help this patriarch Zen. So when you do the practicing of the patriarch Zen, it's not asking you to stop doing anything. You just practice asking the questions and raising doubts in all situations. When you think that you have to do something in order to show that you're practicing, that is the attachment that you had, and you're already attaching to the thinking in your mind. You're doing it and still practice asking the questions and raising doubts. You have to correct yourself first, and then everything outside will follow you, follow your practice. So it depends on how you how much you attach, then you will have your practice accordingly. When the, just like the Buddha said that, the patriarch said that when you still attaching, you're running after all the thinking. But when you doing the practice correctly, then all the thinking will follow you. So that talk seemed like contradiction to each other. But that's a way of our practice. So some people wondering what when we attaching, we running after the thinking, all the thinking, but when we get enlightenment, all the thinking will follow us. And they were wondering why the patriarch is going against the Buddha words. They don't know that all these thinking in the head lure them away from the thinking, from the practicing. When we still attach to the thinking, we won't be able to do our practice correctly. So if you know that you are thinking, you're attaching to your thinking, then you just have to go back to ask the questions and raising doubt. An example that when unmarried man doing the practicing, sometimes he had the thinking that he had to divorce his wife in order to practice correctly. When you have the thinking in your head, which means you're still attaching to the practice, you're still attaching to the thinking created by your mind. Marriage life is not a problem for anyone to practice. You can still practice when you are in a marriage or you're still in doing anything. You have to do the practice diligently, and eventually you can do it in all situations. So the habits of thinking and running after the thinking have been with us for too long, and we won't be able to get rid of them when we in thinking. But when you do in practice, slowly, eventually, we will be able to stay away from all these thinking arising in your head. But when you see any thought arising in your head, it's a reminder for you to go back to your practice. So the understanding and the practicing are totally different. When you understand, you just talk the talk. But when you do in the practice diligently, that is walking the walk. When you start your practice, and eventually you will believe in your Buddha nature more and more, you build up a fundamental concept or the foundations for your practice, and eventually you will believe in yourself, your Buddha nature, more and more. And the main way to do it is to ask questions and raise in doubt. Don't just say that you detach yourself from all the thinking, but practice by asking questions and raising doubt. And eventually, when you can practice diligently and seriously, the doubt automatically doing the job for you. The doubt will strip up every thought or all the thinkings arising in your head, in your mind. So just do practice, and whatever that you're dealing with, still do in your practice. In all situations, all times, when you know that you is not doing your practice, then go back to ask question and raising doubt. It's just like the Sikh patriarch helped Pháp Đạt to to believe in his practice. Chanting the Buddha names and chanting the sutra is not a fault. The fault is because he attaching to what he's doing. And that's why the patriarch has helped him to detach himself from that. So is that understandable? She's understand, but still having a questions about belief in a Buddha nature. Could you please give us some more words about belief in the Buddha nature? So in the booklet, let's explain that when you believe in the Buddha nature, which means you believe in the practice that you're doing. And when you're doing the practice diligently, seriously, eventually you will believe more and more in your own Buddha nature. So
cái ngã chấp cũng là tinh tự tâm. Tất cả các pháp, không có pháp nào không có chỉ cái niềm tin tinh tự tâm, mà do tại mình không.
When you believe in your Buddha nature, you detach yourself from all the thinkings, even the thinking believe in the Buddha nature. You have to practice, and the doubt will automatically detach that for yourself. And or the sutra from the Buddha always asking people, his disciple and all practitioner, to detach themselves from all the thinking by doing the practice. You have to start a practice first and do it seriously and diligently, and then eventually you will gain your own belief when you get close to your Buddha nature. When you believe in your Buddha nature, you have nothing to gain, nothing to fear, and nothing to ask for. It's just like having a pearl, the clear pearl that can reflect everything coming close to it. And everything is ready, everything is enough in your Buddha nature. And when you believe that, you really doing the practice, and that all. We run out of time.